Okay, so we have installed and configured Sentry and have the plugins installed with Hive and HDFS. Now what we need to do is basically we need to see that how the authorization can be done using Sentry. Okay, so basically in ActiveDirectory you need to create a group called Hive Server, add users into that whom you want to get the Hive privileges. We'll see that whether we is in the Hive, we need to create an admin role and assign it to the group called Hive users. And then it won't user add. Okay, so we'll try to this. So in Hive users, we already have that group, right? Somewhere here in Hive. So we are having CDH users. So let's give this CDH user 1 and user 2 is the part of this. User 1 and user 2. CDH devs are the part of. So we will assign some roles to that. So in ActiveDirectory you need to create a group called Hive users. So we will, instead of this, we will use the CDH devs and users into that whom you want to have Hive privileges. In Hive we need to create a admin role and assign it to the group called which one? CDH devs. So let's do that. Switch user Hive. Apparently Hive user password is not set up. Let me exit out of it. Switch user Hive. So it is not set up. So we will use the key tab now. Okay. We don't have to be Hive user. We can say knit and this is the thing. So basically if you do klist, currently there is no credential. So just run this. Sudo. So, this one 513 Hive server 2. So basically what happens is it keeps changing depending on the key tabs getting generated whenever we restart the cluster, though it should not change, but I'm not sure why it is so. Okay, so in this CD, let me just go and check if there is a Hive key tab into it or not. So yeah, Hive key tab is there. Okay, so we can use this one now. Okay, so let me run it. What it's saying? Key list is not coming. Okay, so actually I picked the Hive server 2 folder is like this. Okay, 532. So it actually keeps changing when you restart the thing, so you need to pick the correct one. So 532. So 532 is here. Hive server 2, inside that you will find the key tab of HDFS, for Hive. And we ran this command and we need to be within sudo hyphen I. Okay, so either you can use sudo in front of it or sudo hyphen I also will work, and then just generate the key tab in that. Okay, so obtain the TGT using this key tab. Okay, so in Cloudera sometimes it is a bit clumsy in order to find which proper key tab with which you can generate the Kerberos ticket. Okay, so we have now the Kerberos ticket, valid Kerberos ticket for Hive. What we need to do is now is we run the beeline. Okay, so for beeline we require CDHM2, so here we are running it. So once you get that, let's try to see if the things are working properly, databases. Yes, so we are able to see that. Now we need to create a role called admin. I'm creating it. Then grant all on server 1 to role admin with grant option. Okay, so you can grant further one to the other ones. And instead of Hive users, what I will do is basically I will use CDH Dave's over here, right? So grant role admin to group called CDH Dave's. CDH Dave's, right? CDH Dave's. So this is done. Then add the user whom you want to get the Hive privileges below. Okay, so it won't add the group locally, but the Linux will create a mapping between user and okay. So basically, now we do have CDH user one, right? Who should be the part of this group already in Hive. So what I will do is I will let me first try whether the CDH user will get the permission. So let me just log out.
Vivant, are you on mute?
Oh, sorry. I was on mute. So what I did is basically, sorry for that, but actually the voice should have been recorded now. Recording was on. So what I did is basically I went to see, I have obtained the Kerberos ticket. Okay. And then I ran the beeline command in that Hive. Basically I ran the, you know, grant. So first I have created a role, okay, admin, okay, over here, create a role admin, then grant all the server, grant all on server one to role admin with grant option, okay, and then assign this role admin. This admin role is assigned to the group called CDH Dave's. Okay, so this is from the Active Directory. We are having CDH Dave's whose part. Just try to open and see the members of it. We do have CDH user one and user two. Okay, so if I CDH user one and its password is this, let me log in and try to do some show databases. The good thing is that we don't require to run flush privileges just like in any other databases. Okay. So if I go on currently, let me just see if it is a part of CDH Dave's. So currently default, what about, okay, just leave it. Let's see if this user able to run any command on Hive or not. The problem is basically Sentry looks on to the local file system and try to find that if this groups whoever we have assigned the permission locally, that group is assigned or not, the group is there or not. So we may need to run this thing, okay. Though it may not add the Hive users group directly onto your system, but it will make a part that it will make this guy to the part of this group. Okay, and then since this group is allowed locally to get the permission as a grant role admin, grant on it. So basically anyone who is under this user group will be able to access the things through Hive. So now if I do show databases, definitely I should get some error. And see, the error is there. At least now the Sentry authorization is working at least. Okay, this error is telling us that Sentry authorization working and it is stopping this user to, you know, get the accesses to the database. Okay, so he is not able to see any database. Okay, he is not having any command on that. So what I will do is let me run this on over here. Just let me come out of it. I should have one more session. Okay, sudo -i and sudo user g users. That does not exist. CDH Dave's. Okay, so currently it's saying that CDH user one, we are trying to observe. CDH Dave's does not exist. So I'm not sure. Okay, so what we may require is to, you know, add this machine as a part of our Active Directory. Then only this will use. Otherwise, we may need to create this. Okay, so currently, why it should not ask basically, because I think when I was doing this, I had made this complete machine to be the part of our Active Directory. Okay, so that also is one of the good ways. I mean, we should sync all the users and groups from the Active Directory directly onto our machine. But let me just have this group to be added locally. So I will say, what is that command? Group add. And we can now run this. Okay, so now the CDH user is a part of CDH Deus group. Okay, and since we have assigned the permission to CDH Deus over here, now let me just try to and see. You have got it. Now this user has now got the permission to get the show the thing. So what we did is here. We created this CDH Deus locally, though it should not be created locally because it should be synced from the Active Directory. So you need to create, you need to have this machine to be the part of the Active Directory then. Okay, so you already know that how to do that. Okay, so if you do that, then we need not to create the CDH Deus group locally on our local machine where the Sentry server and High server 2 is running. Okay, so now since this particular CDH Deus group is having the admin privileges, and any user under this particular group should be able to work with Sentry now. Okay, so we are now working through Heave, that is Kerberized, and Sentry is Kerberized. So the other thing is, you may not able to see, because as soon as you add the Sentry's service principle should also have been created over here. The good thing is that if you see the HDP organization unit, all the principles are like can be judged that okay, so this is for name node, this is for nimbus and all. Okay, but in CDH user, when you see these are all like encrypted. Okay, nobody knows that which particular user principle, these are a user principle, but which user principle is for which, nobody knows. Okay, so that is the good thing about Cloud Run Manager. Okay, it is actually encrypting everything. Okay, so now this shows you that how to authorize any user in order from using Sentry authorization on Hive basically. Okay, now he can do show tables, he can also create a database. I will say create database Hadoop _ example, and if you just see hit enter, it should be able to create it. And now if you do show databases again, two databases, you should be able to see two databases now. One is default and another one is Hadoop. So he's a kind of admin guy now who can do a lot of things. Now this is the complete privileges. Now you can create multiple roles depending on what you want to do with whatever roles. Okay, someone can grant, some can. So you just need to know that how, because again it is SQL. Okay, you need to manage this through SQL. It is not some just like in Ranger, everything is through web UI. You will create policies and everything will be drop down menu, and you can just assign those policies to certain groups or users. It is not like that over here in Sentry. You need to go on the Hive and try to create all the roles and assign the roles to different groups and assign users to that groups, and those users will then do the things either through Hive or through Beeline. Also can be like that. Okay, so now through Hive and through Beeline this thing will work. Okay, Hive should not be used directly. What happens if I run Hive? I'm not sure. Because so it is allowing. The warning is okay, but I'm not sure how to have this stopped Hive. Okay, Hive should not come up at all. This is the data. Okay, so this is how the Sentry authorization can be in place in order to restrict the users to do something and allow some users to do something. So as an exercise, you can do further, you know, sync of this, what, just try to explore what all other things Sentry can do. But ultimately, it is just authorization. Okay, we need to create on the backend some rules and regulations, rules and, you know, and assign them to the users and group. That's it. So it is just like kind of all it is, you know, ultimately being played in Hive only mostly, because all these admin roles and everything we have run in Hive. Okay.
Vimant, questions?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Can you stop the recording and you record?